Hello once again, witchy people. Speaking very quickly, I have literally 5 minutes to record this video. I am moving today. Today is moving day. Me and the puppies and the cats are moving today. So, it's been very hectic. As you can see, we have puppy pads on the floor and daughter's washing, still up on the guard here. She moved out, I think it's 3 weeks ago, I'm not sure. Time means very little to me at the moment. just don't ever get a puppy when you're moving, or better still, never move. It's just too much hassle. Moving's fine. The solicitors that we have chosen for us are absolute holes. Anyway, so a few weeks ago we did get the puppy. She's doubled in size. She was named Lady Woofington. She no longer is, because Lady and Barclay were too close, sort of like that phonetically end sounding, and they were getting confused. So she is now called Cinnamon. Cinnamon Freckles. Do you want to come up? Cinnamon? Hop up. Oh, good girl. There we go. Say hello to everyone. She's like, no. Oh, there, look. What's that? Oh, who's that? That's you. That's you. Say hello. This is Cinnamon Freckles. She's a bit naughty at the moment, but she is a Cocker Spaniel and they tend to be a bit boisterous. Barclay is trying to teach her manners. Aren't you, baby boy? And he's been brilliant with her. We've been so lucky. Barclay, come on then. Don't bite him. This little boy has been amazing, haven't you, Barclay? Yes, he has been amazing. Absolute diamond. Haven't you? Yes, we shall be proud of you, aren't we? Are we proud of our Barkers? Yes, we are. There you go. Say hi, everyone. Hi, everyone. There you go. Good boy. So, yeah, that's Cinnamon and Barclay, you already know. But yes, I just wanted to let you know that I am moving today, just me and the animals. The people that are moving into this house are seemingly a really, really lovely couple. And they've got two huskies, so the garden's going to be well used. And if you can hear anything strange, Barclay has just eaten the puppy's food and the puppy is now eating her bed. Just normal. When you have a new puppy, bit of advice, do not buy a wicker bed. No, 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 no. Because it is just something for them to treat as an extra large chew toy. Anyway, so yes. As you can imagine, I have celebrated nothing recently. But I think getting so close, and it's something that Wendy reminded me of. Hi, Wendy! Wendy Plested. Amazing, amazing woman. She's revealed a few things to me lately that I find fascinating, but, you know, get to know her, she'll tell you. She's on Facebook. Anyway, my transitioning, obviously my path, because we talked about this whole re-naturalising, reworking, can I have that for a moment? Thank you. Yes, and this whole transitioning from my path here to how it's going to be in the new home, and then when I get to live with my mother-in-law. Give me that, especially now. That transitioning period is and change. Has synchronised very well with Yule, and I'm hoping that's a really good sign for that sign of change and getting closer to family, you know. So although I won't be physically close to my mum anymore, obviously I still see her and I still speak to her. It's not that far, and yeah, not that far, she says, and she's already missing her daughter. My daughter only lives in Dorchester, and I am, oh, I can't even, no, I miss her so much. But yes, so kind of like a nice coincidence. I've still got the ball. You can wait. kind of like a nice synchronization there of my changes and yours. So hopefully, like I said, fingers crossed and everything else, it's going to be, once it's all done, hopefully by January, we're hoping it's all going to be settled and I can have my own work shed, craft shed. I'll get my roots done, I'll get my nails done, because these are all broken. This is what housework does to you, serious housework. So anyway, and I'd like to thank you all for kind of like sticking with me whilst I'm going through this change. Sounds bad, but whilst I'm going through the change, been there, done that. whilst my life is changing so much and I haven't been on it and I haven't been interacting, thank you so much for sticking with me and, you know, still being a subscriber and being very loyal. And I think you're all wonderful. I do. And every little comment I get is just like, you know, there's a connection there to people and it means so much. And I know I've said this before and I've said it often, but it does. It means an awful lot that all those little connections, it's important. Anyway, that's it. I'm going to go. The 5 minutes has gone on a bit longer. Crikey, I've got to try and sort these dogs out. I also have to get my clothes put away and finish packing for my journey this evening. And hopefully I will be online again in a few days. But I don't think I'll be showing you the new place until it's a bit tidier. My husband said it's like Mr. Traber's house. I think it was Channel 4. There was this famous guy called Mr. Trabus, and he was a hoarder. And he didn't throw anything away. I mean, I think he had newspapers from the 1920s or something daft. From floor to ceiling, newspapers and just everything. There was no room in his garden. I think that I found a 1950s or 1940s car underneath all the undergrowth in his garden. And that, Mr. Traber's house is very similar to what the bungalow looks like now. But we are downsizing a lot. We're moving to a smaller place with less rooms and with no storage. And this is something that really we took for granted in this house, just how big the rooms are, how many rooms we had, and the amount of storage we have here is amazing. So good luck to the next people that live here, who, absolutely lovely. Alicia is the lady's name. Can't remember the man's name. They have two huskies, which I think they're huskies. I don't think they're malamutes. I do think they're huskies. And so the garden's going to get a really good workout. That's it. I'm going. I've waffled. Thank you so much, witchy people. I'll be back very soon, somewhere new. Bye for now.